What are some typical closing costs you can expect to pay when buying a home? The answer can vary if you purchase your home using cash or financing. Since most people in the United States purchase a home using a loan, this video will tell you what you can expect to pay at the closing table. Keep in mind that different states and loan programs may have other requirements that are not discussed in this video. It is highly recommended that you talk to a trusted local title company and lender to get a better estimate of the closing costs for your particular method of financing. The typical closing costs include your down payment, initial escrow account payment, lender origination charge, title company fees, and prorations. Now let's explore each one of these items in more detail. Down payment is the cash payment you make at the start of the loan. This is showing your level of investment to the lender, or in other words, your skin in the game. Down payments for mortgages can range from 3.5% of the sales price all the way to 20% or higher. In Houston, there are even some loan programs that offer 0% down payment and down payment assistance. Initial escrow payment. Most people choose to have an escrow account. This allows you to pay your property taxes and home insurance as part of your monthly payment. Each month, you accumulate more and more money, and at the end of the year, your bank will pay your property taxes and insurance on your behalf. If you choose to have an escrow account, most lenders will ask you to pay a couple months in advance at closing. Lender origination charge. This is the lender's fee for helping you secure the loan. Lender's fees can vary, so it's important to ask your lender for a loan estimate sheet before you start your search. Title company fees. The title company also charges a small amount to prepare documents and record the deed at closing. Prorations. Many people do not close on the first day or last day of the year. Therefore, taxes and homeowners association fees are prorated until the day of closing. The seller usually will give a credit to the buyers for taxes, and the buyer will give a seller a credit for the HOA payment. It works like this. Say your closing date is in June. Since taxes are not due till the end of the year, the seller will give the buyer a credit for the tax payment from January through June. HOA payments are made at the beginning of the year, so the buyer will give a credit to the seller for payments from June through December. The good news is that it may be possible to reduce the amount of your closing costs. The seller can agree to pay all or a portion of your costs. Be sure to talk to your lender to see if your particular loan program allows a seller contribution before you negotiate this important detail. I hope this video was helpful in understanding the closing costs you can expect when you buy a home. Please contact me if you have any questions about purchasing a home in Houston. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube for more real estate tips. Take care. Bye.